Do you ever find yourself avoiding leftovers because they never taste as good the second time around? Well, it could have to do with how you be reheating them. And our Michelle Oliver gets tons of leftovers from her Dine in the D shoots, so she had to master how to warm them up and is sharing her best ways to do just that. Take a look.
Are you sick of subpar leftovers? Well, number one, stay away from the microwave. When you're reheating food, the number one thing you want to worry about is maintaining the texture of the food. If your fries were crispy the night before, you want them to be crispy again, not a soggy mess, which is what you'll get if you put them in the microwave. So here are six common foods that I'm going to show you how to reheat so that they taste like they were freshly made, or at least close to it. And why not start with the fries? Just turn your oven on broil so all the heat's up at the top, creating a nice toasting effect. Then we're going to take our fries and spread them across a cookie sheet. I like to line mine with parchment paper just so the fries don't stick to the pan. Then we're going to put them in the oven on the top rack. Occasionally, you'll want to mix them up just so they don't get one side more toasted than the other. And then after about 5 minutes, they should come out perfectly crispy. Pizza is another dish I like to heat up in the oven. If you have a pizza stone, like I do, place it in your oven and heat it to 350 degrees. You want the stone to warm up with the oven. If you don't have a stone, you can always use a pizza pan like this one or a regular cookie sheet. Place the pizza in the oven, and when you see the cheese start to remelt, you know it's done. Now, I personally would not reheat steak. In my opinion, it just never turns out as good as it is originally. But when I looked on Google, steak was one of the most searched items as to how to reheat. So we're doing it. And I think this method will work pretty well. So the first step is leaving your steak out so that it comes to room temperature. Put your pan on low heat and then add just a little bit of beef stock or beef broth, whatever you happen to have at home. Place your steak in there and put a lid over top. What you wanna do is steam the steak and slowly raise up its temperature. Wait until it heats thoroughly through, then at the end, you're going to give it a nice sear. And if you're really good, your steak will stay cooked perfectly. For the pasta, we're going to use a very similar method to what we did for the steak. Put your pan on low heat, and then you're going to put your pasta into the pan. Now, the trick when it comes to reheating pasta is to not have it get too dry. So you're going to add a liquid to it. This could be water or wine, or in my case, I'm going to add in a little bit of beef stock. It really depends on the base of the sauce. And then cover it up and let it steam. Once it's reheated, bon appetit. If you made too many pancakes the morning before, save them and then reheat them using the toaster. It gives them a nice crisp, almost like they're griddled edge, and the center warms up beautifully. And finally, the only thing I think you should put in a microwave is rice. Just add a little bit of water, cover it up, and put it in the microwave for about 30 seconds to start. Then stir it up and check and see how much longer you need to put it in for. And there you have it. That's how I would heat up my leftovers.
Pizza also works in a skillet. You should try, especially a cast iron skillet. Michelle will post her detailed instructions on Live in the D's page on clickondetroit.com following today's show.